abominable. We are here to celebrate with them. We are here to give you thanks for giving us grace to be partakers of this great celebration of life. Receive our praise, O Lord. Take all the glory and honor. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Ghost, sweet Holy Spirit, come and join us, come and lead us, come and teach us. Illuminate this environment. Put more joy in the heart of everyone here. And take all the glory forever. In Jesus' mighty name.
Holy, the righteous and the world. Holy. Oh,
2 Corinthians chapter 5, from 5 to, from verse 1 to 10. For we know that in our earthly house of this tabernacle, where dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. For in this we groan earnestly, desiring to be clothed upon with our house, which is in from heaven, which is from heaven. Verse 3. If so be that, being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we will be unclothed, but clothed upon, that mortality might be swallowed up of life. Verse 5. Now he that wrought us for the same self, for the self same thing, is God, who also hath given unto us the earnest of the Spirit. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. 7. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Wherefore, we labor, that whether present or absent, we may be accepted of him. 10. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, and everyone may receive the things done in his body, according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Mrs. Gates Yekorani Arubi was born on the 18th of October 1962 in Warri, where she attended her primary school. She also attended Anglican Women's Teachers College in Benin, where she obtained a Grade 2 Teacher's Certificate. She went on to acquire a Diploma in Theatre Arts from the University of Port Harcourt. She also obtained a National Certificate of Education from National Teachers Institute, Kaduna. She worked as a teacher in Air Force Primary School in Kaduna, Makurdi, and Port Harcourt before resigning to pursue her passion in fashion designing. In 1987, she got married and was blessed with 4 children, 3 boys and a girl. She was a loving and caring wife, mother, sister, and friend. Mrs. Gates Yekorua was a highly dedicated child of God who had a passion for evangelism. You could hardly have a conversation with her without her shipping in the Word of God. Wherever she lived, she made it a core duty to go from streets to market to buses preaching the Word of God. Even on her deathbed, she kept praying and interceding for others. And with the song, "Move on to the right hand side, move on to the right hand side, move on to the right hand side of God," in her mouth at the last moments, we have no doubt that she has stepped into paradise. Praise the Lord.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
righteous, doing that which pleases you alone. We return all glory, we return all praises unto thee. In the name of Jesus, Father, thank you. Let's invite the Spirit of the Most High God. Let's ask the Holy Spirit to come and take us through this session successfully. Let's invite the Spirit of the Most High God to come and take absolute control. Jesus, Holy Spirit of God, into your word this day, this moment, Lord, let your word transform us. Let your word take us to the next level. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. For in Jesus' precious name we are praying. Praise the Lord. Let's give Jesus a big clap of praise to take our seats. All our covenant parents. All the covenant fathers, they were buried by their children. Irrespective of the age of our sister today, the good thing here is that you, the children, you are the one that is burying her, not the other way around. So I want you to rejoice. I ask the young man to continue singing, but see the way you children you are doing as if God has done wrong. It's a lie. In fear. If you are, our God is faithful. Yes, we are pain, but God has healed our pain. The Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, in everything give thanks. In everything give thanks. Whether our mommy is alive, give thanks. We know from the testimony of yesterday and this morning, even from our biography, and above all, the last song. I thought we were going to complete the song. The last song she sang. So to tell us that truly she's on the other side with the Lord. So let's rejoice. Let's rejoice. Let's rejoice. Praise the Lord. Yes, we are pained, but our God is faithful. The Bible says in Psalm 116, verse 15 also, it said, precious is the what? The death of the saint in the sight of the Lord. Precious, not ordinary, precious. Indeed, our sister, she's a saint. And she's there. On the last day, we are going to see her. In the mighty name of Jesus. When the trumpet shall sound, we will see her. For those of us in Christ, God will take us through this journey. We will finish well. In the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. So my charge for every one of us this morning is be heavenly focused. Be heavenly focused. Every one of us here, including myself, every one of us, we are here on a journey. From here, peradventure, you came in here by public transport. From, what do you call it, roundabout, you'll be calling the bus stops, you do not drop there until the last bus stop.
Yes.
Because you know where you are going to. The last bus stop, you are lighted. So we are all on a journey. Our sister has gotten to her own bus stop and she has alighted. In the name of Jesus. If Jesus tarries, we will all finish well. We will get to the bus stop. And our goal will be to make heaven. And we will not miss it. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, and believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. There are many mansions, not room and parlor, not room self-contained, not room and parlor self-contained, mansions. There are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. So I am going to prepare the way for you. jokingly, our bishop will always say, when you go early, you go and prepare the way for us. Our sister has gone to prepare the way for us. And through and through, we will see her. In the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 3 says, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Where I am, there ye may be also. I am going. There are many mansions in my Father's house. I am going to prepare the place for you. So, number one, if you are a Christian, let your heart focus on the mansion above. Forget the earthly mansion. That scripture that was read to us in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, from verse 1 to 10, one of them say, we go off this earthly body and take up heavenly body. So, let us be heavenly focused. Let us be heavenly focused. And if you are heavenly focused, there are certain things that you must do. Me and you must do. What are the things? Philippians chapter 4. Philippians chapter 4. Verse 8 says, finally, brethren, whatsoever able to say the truth at all times, even if they put AK-47 on your neck and you know that this is the truth, say it at all times. Whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest. We heard yesterday, one of our mommies gave a testimony that at a point, our sister got closer to our younger ones more than herself again. Why? Maybe because she always tell them the truth. Be honest to them. Be honest to them. Check yourself. How honest are you? Can any man or woman, can your husband, can your wife, can your sister, can your brother vouch for your honesty? Check yourself if you are heavenly focused. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue and if there be any praise, think on those things. When you begin to ponder on the truth, being honest, being pure, being just, live a life of a righteous man or woman, then your heart is focused in heaven. Things around us make us forget that there is heaven. I've heard some even saying there's no heaven. Yes, there's no heaven. None of us would not be there to know. But I know my Bible tells me that there is heaven. 1 Corinthians chapter 15. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 9. The Bible says, 19. 1 Corinthians 15 verse 19. In this life only, if we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most what? Miserable. If this is where our hope is and not heaven, then it's as good as not coming to this world at all. It's as good as not coming to this world at all. Be heavenly focused. After your time on earth is up, where do you want to go to? Is it heaven or hell? The choice is yours. If like I said, some will even say there's no heaven, there is no hell. But from the Bible, those of us that are believers, we know whatever that is written in the Bible, it is for our own admonition. Then let's go to the Bible and see whether there is hell or heaven. Luke chapter 16 from verse 19. The Bible says, there was a certain rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen and fed sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus which was laid at his gate full of sores. 21. And desiring to be filled with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. 22. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. The beggar, the righteous beggar, died and angels carried him to heaven. The angels, they've taken our sister to heaven. What we have here now is just a heavenly body. The spirit is long gone. But what happened to the rich man? The rich man also died and was buried, meaning forgotten. Forgotten. Whether there is heaven or hell, the Bible says there is heaven or hell. Now, for time's sake, verse 23, I will skip that one. Verse 24 says, and he cried and said unto Abraham, have mercy on me and send Lazarus. Can you imagine that? As far as the rich man was concerned, messenger, send him, Joe. Unknown to him, according to Orima, levels has changed. Do you want to enjoy here and suffer in hell? But you still have opportunity to enjoy here and to still make heaven. You still have the opportunity to enjoy here, enjoy every good thing in life here, and still make heaven. Abraham, the Bible says Abraham was rich. God made him to be rich, and yet he made heaven. And he cried, said, send Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. Where is flame? Hell. But Abraham said, son, remember that thou in thy lifetime received thy good things. What you think to be good things is of no use now. It's of no use now. You have enjoyed that already. You have enjoyed that already. And likewise, Lazarus, evil things. But now he is comforted and thou art tormented. In the name of Jesus, none of us will be tormented. Amen. We will be comforted. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. The long and short of the story, there is heaven and there is hell. So saith my Bible and your own Bible. So let's be heavenly focused. Let's be heavenly focused. There is no man or woman that can comfort you. It is only God Almighty. It's only God Almighty through the Spirit of God that can comfort you people. Therefore, that Spirit of God will comfort each and every one of you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I always say jokingly, when I go to areas like this, places like this, I'm now talking to my daddy now and the children. You see all this crowd? After today, when we lowered our mommy, if they call you, sir, you thank God. Don't just quarrel if you don't see them again. It is not as if they don't have you in their heart, but time. But there's one person, 247, that cannot leave you people of God. So if you don't know him, this is a time you learn to have good working relationship with the Holy Spirit. It's not as sick, like I said. I told one woman, she lost her husband. As I was leaving, I told her this, and you can only say it. Come home, you see all of us coming here today. The day we bury your husband, we'll hardly come home. It's not as if we don't want to come, but with the time factor. But don't leave God Almighty. Don't leave the Holy Spirit. Hold on to Him. 24/7, He won't leave you. So my children, please hold on to the Spirit of God. Whatever you desire, and you know that, with my mom is alive, God can do 20, 30, 1,000 times more than your mom. So hold on to God Almighty. Yes, it's painful. It's painful. But thank God you see our father. Me, I'll be orphan. So if not, I can't go orphanage home already. Thank God you see our father. So still thank God that at least there is a father. And hold on to God Almighty. Pray for your father. Pray for the family. The Yorubas will always say, Ojo Ajina Sirahu. So those of you that grew up in Lagos here, Ojo Ajina Sirahu. Is your duty? Ojo the same thing. At least if you confuse me. Everybody look at this man. So at 57, if she passed on at what age now?
57.
Is it supposed to be 58? 62, we said now. She'll be 62, she'll be 58 next month. This month we're in our hands. Okay. We are very now. She's 58 already. HIV Aolo passed on before 100. The children held on to her bed and said they will bury her the day she will clock 100, so that it will be 100. So she's 58 already. So at 58, if Jesus tarries, each and every one of you will pass that age.
Amen.
You will not just pass that age, but in sound health.
Amen.
With your children.
Amen.
Your wives.
Amen.
And your husband.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So hold on to God. He will take you through this journey successfully. Be heavenly focused. Your mom is there. She'll be praying for you people also too. And none of you will miss heaven.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Your word in the heart of everyone that heard me this morning. Lord, cause each and everyone, including myself, to be heavenly focused. That in this journey, we will not end it here alone on the earth, but we will end it in heaven.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, mighty Father, Lord. For in Jesus' precious name we are praying.
To this earth. So in everything they continue to give thanks. The God of heaven should strengthen them, unite them, and make them to see that Jesus is the way. And this is the way they will walk all through the days of their lives. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you in Jesus' precious name. Heavenly Father, we thank you today. We give you glory. We thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for the protection of life. We thank you for the gift of salvation. Take all glory. You have done all this well today. We return the glory back to you in the name of Jesus. We hand over the family into your hand this morning. Father, comfort them. Uphold them. In the name of Jesus, I decree longevity of life for them. In the name of Jesus. And to the children, where their mother has stopped, you shall be 100 times better. In the name of Jesus. Their mother served God all through to the end. They shall also serve God all through the days of their lives. In the name of Jesus, I decree the spirit of unity to remain amongst you. In the name of Jesus, none of you will disappoint God. None of you will disappoint yourself. In the name of Jesus, you shall serve God. You shall be blessed by God. And to the Father, I decree that God will comfort you and uphold you, and you will remain focused all all the years of your life. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
None of you will stray away from God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
None of you will falter.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
None of you shall be stranded.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The God of heaven that your mom has served, that same God is still with you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen. To the children, you shall all excel.
Amen.
You shall be excellent in all ways.
Amen.
You shall be grounded in God.
Amen.
I release the peace of God to remain upon each and every one of you. Affliction will never arise the second time. In the name of Jesus. No infant of death in this family any longer. In the name of Jesus. A child amongst you shall die at 100. In the name of Jesus. Peace be unto you. And those that have come around, I decree longevity of life. You will never weep over any of your children. None of you will ever die young any longer. In Jesus' precious name we are prayed.
Yeah.
Peace in Jesus' precious name.
We commit the body of our beloved sister Mrs. Gate Yeburua into Mother Earth. Heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Do it. Heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Anybody okay? Heart to heart, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Are we true? And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, Blessed are the dead who died in the Lord. Yea, seeth the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their work do follow them. In the mighty name of Jesus, the good work of our beloved sister, we follow you, the children.
Amen.
We follow the entire family.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So let's lift up our hands and begin to magnify the name of the Lord.
Father,
let's thank Him. Let's appreciate Him. Lord, we bless your name. I am that I am and you pray. Be thou exalted and be thou glorified. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty Father, Lord. To you alone be all the glory. To you alone be all the praises. For in Jesus' precious name we are praying. Father, we thank you. We are going from your presence to your presence. In the name of Jesus. The next time we will hear from this family again, it will be for celebration of your goodness. For the celebration of your faithfulness in their home. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. That whatsoever is the heart desire of the children, Lord God Almighty, before the end of this year, December, I pray, O Lord, that you grant it unto them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. For in Jesus' precious name, we pray.
Amen.
Mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
Okay.